إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار الإمام ابن رجب الحنبلي قال من لم يعرف ثواب العمل ثقلت عليه في جميع الأحوال الإمام ابن رجب الحنبلي said he who does not know the value and the reward from the deed or the task or the action ends up feeling that the deed or the duty is heavy burden on him. يقول الإمام ابن الجوزي من تخايل الثواب خف عليه العمل. الإمام ابن الجوزي said he who visualizes the reward then he would feel the burden of the task would become easy for him to do and to act upon. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I am the first and the foremost in Islam among the Arabs, Suhayb among the Romans, Bilal among the people of Habasha, Salman among Persia. Allah Almighty said, ثم أورثنا الكتاب الذين اصطفينا من عبادنا فمنهم ظالم لنفسه ومنهم مقتصد ومنهم سابق بالخيرات بإذن الله. Allah says in Surah Al-Fatir, when we gave the book, that is the Quran, as inheritance to such of our slaves whom we chose as followers of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of them, here the Quran gives three types of performances, three types of people how they perform. From them, of them, are some who wrong their own selves, those who completely neglected the commands of Allah, which are the disbelievers. And of them are some who follow a middle course, that is those who act based to show people what they are doing because people are seeing them. And of them are some who are by Allah's will are foremost in good deeds that are indeed a great of grace. The third type is the people who are far beyond everybody else in their performance, in their reach towards Allah Azza wa Jal. They are the best performers, always chasing the biggest opportunities, the fastest way, and the best performance ever. One day the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to his companions and he said to them, who among you is fasting today? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, I am. He said, who among you went to a funeral today? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, I am. He said, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who among you visited the sick today? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, I am. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whosoever has these three characters in him, he is definitely into heaven. Imagine, as the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that moment, watching what the dialogue between Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These few words ignited their performance level. These few words motivated them that these only three actions would guide them into heaven. This short talk made them feel the power and the energy to perform at their best. قال الحسن, he said to you and me, he said, the challenge in performance is that you compete with those who perform the best in your deen. If you see somebody performing better than you, try to be at his level. Always have your eyesight on those who are better than you in the relationship between them and Allah Almighty, and ask Allah Almighty, you become at their level. Wahib ibn Walid said, if you are able to be at the forefront and no one can exceed you in your way to reaching out to Allah Almighty, then be that one. Compete towards reaching Allah and be the fastest and the foremost person to reach towards pleasing Allah. Ahmed ibn Harb said, I am amazed to those who know that heaven is prepared on daily basis above them, and they know that hellfire is increasing in heat below them, and yet they remain idle, not doing anything. Al-Imam Ibn Jawzi said in one of his letters to his son, he said, let that be known that every day consists from hours, and every hour consists of pulses and breaths that you take, inhale and exhale, and every breath you take is locked up in a vault or in a safe that will not be open to be tested until Yawm al-Qiyamah. Therefore, don't you ever let a single breath go unaccounted for. Otherwise, on the Day of Judgment, you will feel sorry for every single pulse and breath that went without remembering Allah Almighty. Then you will feel the grief forever. And that is based on the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, whoever he says, Subhanallah al-Azim wa bihamdihi, just by saying this word, Allah will have a palm tree grown for him in his place in heaven. أقول ما تسمعون وما استغفر الله ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور. Tell me, what's the difference? If the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam stood in front of you and he said to any one of us, you do this and that, do you have the nerve to give an excuse for not doing it? Think of this question. If the Prophet Muhammad comes and speaks to you directly, and he asks you to do something, do you have the nerve to give an excuse or hesitate in doing it? Then tell me, what is the difference if the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaks to you directly, or he speaks to you from the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Tell me, what is the difference when Allah Almighty commanded you directly as He commands the prophets, or you will hear His commands when you're reading the Quran? You wouldn't hesitate in the first one, would you? Then what is slowing you down? What is making you drag your feet? What is making you find excuses that are only excuses? Have you ever heard of a businessman who's making loads of money and rewards, and his business is thriving and growing, and he says, I'm sick and tired of how much money I'm making. I don't know what to do with myself. How about the rewards that the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad in what he taught us in deeds and actions, and you know how much you will get in the hereafter in this dunya, and yes, you choose to be an underperformer. Ramadan is the test. Ramadan is the racetrack. Ramadan is the challenge. Ramadan is the competition. Ramadan shows who you really are in trying to reach out for Allah. If any moment you see that your performance, you are dragging your feet, then question yourself. You have an issue. There is a serious problem in you. Imam Ibn Rajab, alhamdulillah, said, "Inna Allah, that Allah Almighty had made the month of Ramadan as a racetrack for the beings and the creatures that Allah has created. And they compete towards reaching out to Allah Almighty. Some of them, they compete and they go fast in their performance, at their best performance, and they win. And others, they chose to stay behind." It is said also, it's only a few days you will fast, that are connected to each other, and it will finish very fast. And in these few days of Ramadan, you will find yourself very easy to do a lot of good deeds. And it's easy to do so because Allah created these days where the good comes out of you very easily. At the same time, you will not find yourself doing any sins or heading towards any sins. Also, your prayers are accepted in Ramadan. Also, in Ramadan, you are spared from hellfire. And if you're a winner, you'll be spared from hellfire forever by performing your best in the month of Ramadan. Those who move very fast with full force to achieve the pleasure of Allah in pleasing Allah Almighty and to be top performers. And therefore, show Allah Almighty how sincere you are in performing your best. In the race of Ramadan, four factors are involved. The first one is ibadat, prayer, fasting, reading Quran, so forth. The second one is your actions, your relationship with other people, your relationship with your family, getting connected to your loved ones and your family and your tribe in checking their condition, asking about them, visiting them, your parents and connecting with them and your relationship with them, your neighbors, how your relationship with them, orphans, so forth. The third aspect is your behavior, in your honesty, in your integrity, in your loyalty, in your justice, in forgiveness, and also in your generosity. The fourth one is in the momentum that you have in yourself, seeking the knowledge about Islam. Don't wait for somebody to teach you about your religion. You should do your own homework. Nowadays you have access to information. In the past it was not available. It is you the one who should educate himself and not to wait for others to push you to move forward. Allah Almighty said in the Quran, سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماوات والأرض. Allah says, race with one another. Notice, race with one another. This means what? There's a competition. You have to compete towards Allah Almighty. In hasting towards forgiveness from Allah and the paradise, the wealth of heaven and earth prepared for those who believe in Allah and His Messenger. So, as Ramadan is very close, a few hours from now, what are the indicators in your mind and in your soul? How much have you planned for Ramadan, for yourself in your relationship with Allah? What are your goals and objectives in Ramadan that you have set already? Or are you only a spectator who only watches people performing while he is sitting laid back? The hadiths of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will find them as you do your self-study. They are short and they give you the key to work towards high rewards. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to you and me, it is said to the person who reads the Quran, elevate in heaven until the last verse of Quran that you had stopped reading. So when you imagine yourself, you read the Quran and you keep on elevating in your place in heaven, would anyone choose to stop? The Prophet Muhammad in many hadiths, and this is a small sample of it, he said, for those who know the reward of people in the first row in the Masjid, the first row of the Masjid, if they knew that these people, how much they are rewarded, they would fight for the place among them. And if they had the chance and opportunity to make a draw where they pick up a name of somebody to become a winner to be in the first row, they would fight to be pushed in the first row of the Masjid. Would you rather stay in the last lines of the Masjid or drag your feet towards the Masjid? Being prepared is a vital task. The preparation is a knowledge. The preparation is setting the objectives in your mind in this 30 days that are yet to come. What you plan to do, what you plan to achieve, what you plan to use every single minute and second to perform in it. Whether it is Salat al-Jama'ah to be among the first in the Masjid, whether it is to perform your wudu as the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told you to do it, whether it is to follow the dua that the Prophet Muhammad taught us to say at every part of the day, every action that we do throughout the day, it is already available for you. Are you serious about performing? Also, your ability to control your eyesight, your tongue in what you say, and your ears what they hear. Al-Hasan al-Basri said in a marvelous statement, he said, I did not look at something, or I said in my tongue something, or I used my hands physically in anything, or I moved my feet, until I evaluate if my action, it is acceptable to Allah Almighty, I will go ahead and do it. Otherwise, I will not do it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, as I finish this khutbah, I remind you of the first two statements that I read to you in the beginning of it, of Imam Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali and Ibn Qayyim. Both of them said, if you cannot visualize the rewards of actions, therefore the task is going to be a burden on you to perform. Therefore the key is in educating yourself. Every action, where did the Prophet Muhammad put the reward in it? Every action that you do, don't do it because other people are doing it. Find out in Islam, when you do it, what is the reward? And the reward that is related to it. Their advice, 800 or 900 or 1000 years ago, these two scholars gave you the key for top performance. I ask Allah Almighty to bless us in the month of Ramadan, and to give us the ability to squeeze every single second and minute, and to be as performers, not as spectators looking at others. عباد الله اعلموا أن الله سبحانه وتعالى أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه باسم فقال جل من قائل إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم اغفر لنا خطأنا وجهلنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وما أنت أعلم به منا. اللهم اغفر لنا جدنا وهزلنا وخطأنا وعمدنا كل ذلك عندنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا. أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير. اللهم أصلح ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا، وأصلح دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا، وأصلح آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا، واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير، واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم هات نفوسنا تقواها وزكيها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وبفضلك عمن سواك. اللهم ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والبغي والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.